Namaskar students, yesterday we have studied menstrual cycle, its four phases: menstruation, which starts at the age of puberty, menarche, menopause. We have studied spermatogenesis, oogenesis, structure of sperm. Now today we will study the next topic, that is fertilization, implantation, then functions of placenta. So our first topic is fertilization. Fertilization, as you know, it is the fusion of sperm, that is the male gamete, with egg, that is the female gamete. Male gamete is haploid, female gamete is also haploid. And when the fusion of male gamete and female gamete takes place, first diploid cell, that is zygote, is formed. When copulation takes place, the semen is released in the vagina of the female. The sperms, they are motile, they have tail, they pass through the cervix and enter through into the uterus, through which they pass into the oviduct, into the ampulla, stomach junction of the oviduct. When the sperm comes in contact with the zona pellucida layer of the egg, it brings some changes in the membrane of the egg and prevents the entry of other sperms. We have studied the structure of sperm, in which the acrosome, or the tip part of the sperm, it has enzymes, hydrolyzed enzymes, which penetrate the zona pellucida and the sperm, it enters into the egg. The diploid zygote is formed by the fusion of sperm and egg. Then after fertilization is the implantation. The zygote formed by the fusion of male and female gamete, it divides rapidly in the isthmus or in the oviduct, and the process is called cleavage. It divides to form 2, 4, 8, 16 cells, which are called blastomeres. The 8 to 16 celled stage is called morula. The morula divides to form blastocyst. The blastocyst enters into the uterus. The blastomeres, or the cells of the blastocyst, they are arranged in two layers. Outer layer is the trophoblast, and the inner is the inner cell mass. The inner cell mass develops into embryo, and the trophoblast is attached to the endometrium of the uterus. Perimetrium, myometrium, and endometrium. So the blastocyst gets embedded in the endometrium. This is called implantation. Then the cells of the trophoblast differentiate into outer and inner layer. The embryo, it is attached to the uterus with the help of a structural and functional unit, that is called the placenta. The functions of placenta: it helps in the transport of nutrients, to the developing fetus or developing embryo, oxygen. It removes CO2, waste material. from the embryo. It acts as endocrine tissue, produces several hormones which maintain pregnancy. Then, after 1 month of pregnancy, the embryo's heart is formed. By the end of second month, fetus develops its limbs and digits, that is hands and legs, fingers. By the end of third month, most of the organ systems are formed. Then, during the fifth month, hair appears on the head. The movement of the fetus is observed in the stomach. After 6 months, the body is covered with fine hair, eyelids, eyelashes are also formed. And by the end of the 9 months of pregnancy, the fetus is completely developed and ready for the delivery. Then next comes the parturition. The average duration when the fetus is in the stomach, it is called the gestation period. The act of expelling the fetus from the mother's uterus is called parturition, or the delivery of the baby is called parturition. It is induced by a complex neuroendocrine mechanism. The parturition originates from the signals that are given by the fetus through the placenta. It is called fetal ejection reflex. Oxytocin hormone is released during this time. After the parturition, or after the baby comes out from the uterus through the birth canal, the mammary glands of the female differentiate, produce milk. It is called lactation. The milk which comes out of the mammary gland during initial days of lactation is called colostrum. It contains several antibodies and nutrients which are useful for the baby. They develop antibodies and immune system of the body. Thank you.